In this experiment, we will look at a simple demonstration of water changing its form from liquid to gas and back to liquid. For this, we will need a large plate. We are using a steel plate here, and an electric kettle and some water. Additionally, we will also require some salt. If you don't have access to an electric kettle to heat the water, you can alternatively take some water in a vessel and heat it on a stove. Fill the water in the kettle and mix in a few spoons of salt to the water. Now turn on the kettle and bring the water to a boil. Once the water is boiling and steam is being released, carefully hold the plate over the kettle so that the steam is touching the plate. Soon, you will notice there are small droplets of water formed on the plate. Where did the water come from? If you run your finger on the droplets, you will see it starts running. When water is heated up to its boiling point, it turns into steam, its gaseous form. This process is called vaporization. When steam comes in contact with the steel plate, which is at a lower temperature, it again turns into water droplets, its liquid form. This process is called condensation. This entire process, where water goes from its liquid form to its gaseous form and back to its liquid form, is called the water cycle. This experiment is similar to what happens in nature's water cycle, where water in liquid form in rivers and ponds turns into water vapor, its gaseous form, in the atmosphere due to sunlight or wind. However, do note, water in water bodies like oceans, rivers, lakes, etc. is converted into water vapor and not steam. Water vapor rises up in the atmosphere and condenses upon reaching colder temperature in the upper atmosphere, forming clouds. Just as rainwater is not salty even though it was once water in the oceans, the droplets of condensed water on the plate in this experiment are not salty because the salt did not evaporate with water and it is still in the kettle. If you taste the water left in the kettle, you will notice it is even more concentrated or salty now. Caution: take help from your teacher or any adult for this experiment. Be very careful and do not go very close to the steam, as this can cause burns.